Child, don't get me to lying. I don't know why she got her leg up like that. Must be that COVID-19.
We saw you guys inseparable. And since April, a lot of people have been speculating, pointing out the fact that they don't see you and the Kardashians hanging out. They saw that you guys unfollowed each other and on social media. And I don't know who has the time to go and like see who's following who and who unfollows who. But nonetheless, there's been a lot of stories. And I think a lot of people are wondering, what happened? Can you fill us in on like why you're not hanging out with them anymore?
You guys can't. I don't even know. I just feel like Kanye was in a place where he really didn't trust anyone with Kim. So I feel like I was the person that was like, "Oh, don't be so close to her because you're so close to her that that kind of had something to do with it."
Have you reached out to her at all to be like, hey, what's going on? Can we like hang out?
A little bit, but I also feel like my personality is the kind of person like I want you to be great. You know what I mean? I don't want to be the trouble in your relationship. If your husband feels like threatened by my relationship with you, then I don't want to be that person. Like I've got my own shit. I don't want to be like that person. Let him feel really comfortable, really secure if I'm not in the picture and just see what happens. Like normally when people put themselves in that situation, like they think it's the other person's fault or whatever when you have issues, like it's really never the other person's fault. You know what I mean? It's like you have to work on your own shit. It has nothing to do with other people, you know? It's almost like when people would say to me, like, what's the one thing that broke you up? Well, it's not one thing that breaks a couple up. It's multiple things. It's not just like one thing. So
How did you feel? Like, who was the first person to, she unfollowed you. When did that happen? Did that, how'd you feel when that happened?
How did I feel? Like I didn't feel any type of way because I just kind of felt like do what's best for your family, you know? Like I love you. You and I are best friends. We've been through everything together. I would never do anything to like, jeopardize our relationship. We're like sisters, we're family. But if you have to unfollow me to make your home a
It's
better place,
4 o'clock.
if you have to unfollow me to make your home a better place, then that do it. You know, I was in a situation when Scotty and I had our issues. He didn't want me to hang out with them. Scotty was not happy about my relationship with them. Scotty was didn't want me to take my kids over their house. We had issues like that too. And I was strong enough where I was just like, I'm not going to let you dictate what I do. Like I'm just not that person. You know, like I was like, no.
So, did you
What?
have like a bad run-in with Kanye? I guess I just don't understand why
No, no.
he would say
It's
like don't hang out with this person or unfollow this
No,
person.
we always had a great relationship. I don't know. When people are not happy, when people are trying to figure out their own shit, I feel like they want to put pressure and blame other people for their situation. And, I've seen that happen so much that it's like, I get it. You know what I mean? I understand. I get it. Like, is it hurtful? 1,000%. It's hurtful that people think like I hooked up, like I'm trying to ruin like Chloe's life. I'm like, dude, I would never do that. Like, that's not even my personality. My personality is all about love and support, and I've been there and I've supported them through everything. So if Kanye feels like Kim and him are better without me, then let them be without me. I'm okay with that. I have my. Do I look like I'm suffering? Do I look like I'm in pain? I'm okay. I will survive. Was it hurtful? Yes. But do I have love from a lot of other places? Yes. So this shall pass too.
Okay, but why Chloe and Courtney too? Because that's separate.
Because he literally has brainwashed the whole family into thinking that, like, I don't even know what. I don't even know. I don't know.
None of them gave you a reason.
No, I swear I don't even know. Like, I know that, like, and like a lot of people know this and a lot of people don't, but he talked so much about me being this and that and this and that. And I feel like I ran into Travis Scott one night at a club, and Travis called Kylie and said that I was hitting on him. And that never happened. So then that was like, oh, well, Kanye says she's this. And then she was hitting on Travis. And I'm like, by the way, that never happened. I came and left with the same people I came with. That never freaking happened. Like, was he delusional? Because I know he raps about him being the highest in the fucking room. So clearly, maybe he was the highest in the fucking room. He imagined all this shit because it never happened. Like, I would never do that. I would never in a billion years do that.
So do you feel that he's brainwashing the family to think that you're trying to ruin relationships that they're in? Like, I'm just trying to get to what he would tell them.
I don't even, I honestly don't even know. That's what I'm trying to say to you. I don't know. He used to call me at 4, 5, and 6 o'clock in the morning. And I was like the person that would take his calls at 4, 5, and 6 in the morning when he wanted to rant. And I would listen to him and I would be like, I love you. You're the best. Like, things will get better. Like, I was his go-to person to call when he wasn't happy with X, Y, and Z. How that turned, maybe because, you know, I blocked him on my phone because I just couldn't bear taking his calls anymore. I was just like, I can't, I'm drained. So I blocked him on my phone. So he, obviously that really upset him. So then he turned that into like, oh, she's this and she's that. And then like, they all started to like ride his wave of I'm this or I'm that, which, I mean, if you're that easily swayed like the wind, then like, do I really give a fuck? Should I give a fuck? I don't know. Like, was I hurt by it? Yes. But at the same time, I'm like, I've done nothing. I've never done one thing. And I've been the most honest and truthful and best friend to all of them.
Okay. And now Larsa is coming out saying that she's been battling COVID for a week. It's no joke. I've never felt pain like this. Well, maybe if you would sit down, put some clothes on and act like there is a pandemic out here in this world, then maybe you wouldn't be battling COVID for a week and feeling like this pain like you've never felt. These celebrities have been out here going to parties, going to weddings, basically trying to still live like we are in normal times just so they can feel like things are normal. We have health precautions, mask precautions in place for a reason, because there is a pandemic and it's going to get worse. Now that we're in the flu season, it's going to get worse. So she's propped up in her bed with her legs all out. I don't know what that has to do with COVID-19, but I'm sure she's trying to thirst trap as usual. And how did you go from Scottie Pippen to Tristan Thompson? Scottie Pippen is played with the likes of Michael Jordan, Charles Barkley. I'm not even going to put Tristan Thompson up there with Kevin Garnett. Tristan Thompson is not even, you know, that great of a basketball player. So how did you go from Scottie Pippen to Tristan Thompson? Then there's a couple things that she said in this interview that I keyed in on. Scottie didn't want her going over to Kim's house when she was married. He didn't even want her taking their kids over there. There's a reason for that. I'm not sure if it's on the part of Kim or if it's on the part of Khloé, but he knows there's whole activity that goes on over there. So he didn't want his wife going over there, and he didn't want her taking the kids over there. And now we got Kanye on the flip side saying that he didn't want her around his wife. He was protective over her. You know, he wants things to be right. You know what I'm saying? He's constantly trying to keep Kim on the right path, trying to keep Kim from going back down that hoe alley that she used to frequent. So we got to start at some time looking at these two women. What is it that your husbands was trying to keep y'all apart for? What is it that y'all got together and used to do when you would get together that they were so worried about when y'all got together? Most women, you know, when they have friends, you know, girlfriends or whatever, and they hang out, they go shopping, they go to the mall, they don't hang around them 7 days a week, 24/7, move in, be on a show with them, act like, you know, they're married to each other. That's not normal. So I'm not really, you know, it doesn't really bother me that Scottie would want his wife to stay home. He didn't want her down to Calabasas around the Kardashians all the time. He didn't want his kids going down there learning, you know, how to be on reality TV. He's trying to bring his kids up normal. He's a black man. So the fact that, you know, Larsa finds herself with COVID-19 doesn't surprise me, because she's out here trying to thirst trap. I can just imagine what club she's going to. I mean, who only knows what she's trying to do? And then in the interview with the ET, she's like, do I look like, you know, I'm hurting for money? Basically, that's what she was insinuating. But I'm looking around and like, girl, look like you sitting on the floor of an apartment, you know, with brown basic carpet. Like, I didn't see anything magnificent that you were, you know, sitting in. Didn't look like it was a penthouse, a condominium or nothing. Looked like it was a basic apartment. So, Larsa, girl, You remind me of Bernice Burgos, or however you say her name. You remind me of an old grandma that needs to go sit down and, you know, just figure out what she's going to do with her life. Start some type of clothing line. Start some type of business, soaps, perfumes, lipsticks, whatever it is that, you know, women start these days. Try to get on Basketball Wives. I mean, I don't know. But to be constantly down there with the Kardashians and sitting up underneath of them, that's not what grown women do. Take care of your kids, you know, get into what it is that your children are doing in their life. I don't even know how old they are now, but figure out what you're going to do with your life and stop worrying about chasing up behind the Kardashians. All right, guys. So let me know what you think about this video. Drop down in the comments. Let me know what you think about Larsa and this whole situation. Did she date Tristan first and Khloé took him from her? Or were they sharing Tristan? Let me know what you think about that. Be sure to like this video, subscribe, and as always, bye.